Hello class 12 students, welcome to Madhu ma'am's class. In this chapter, human reproduction, earlier you have studied about male reproductive system. The most important male reproductive organ is testis, which has about 250 compartments, which is known as testicular lobule. This you have studied in the earlier lecture. Each lobule is filled with connective tissue and contains 1 to 3 seminiferous tubules. Each lobule, it contains 1 to 3 seminiferous tubule, which is the site of this seminiferous tubule. This is the site of spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis, it is performed in the seminiferous tubule. Then what is spermatogenesis? Spermatogenesis is making of sperms. You all are aware, sperms are the male gamete. You can say that seminiferous tubule promotes the function spermatogenesis, or you can say making of sperms takes place inside the seminiferous tubule. The seminiferous tubule, it is surrounded by interstitial spaces. These tubules having some space, and this space is called as interstitial space. This interstitial space contains interstitial cell as well as blood vessels are also present over here. Interstitial cell, it is termed as leading cells also. Leading cells, it is named in the honor of one of the anatomist, F.W. Leding, German anatomist F.W. Leding. He has discovered this interstitial cell, which is located inside the interstitial spaces, and hence this is also named as leading cells. Beside it, what I have said, it also contains blood vessels. In this connective tissue, you can find out two types of cell. One is the spermatogonia, which get differentiated in the spermatocytes, and another is the Sertoli cell. To have a good view, I have also made another figure. This is the enlarged view of this part. This one. It has been shown with this arrow. Here you can see the interstitial space, which contains interstitial cell and blood vessels. Okay. Now the two type of cells, which I have said you earlier, it is present in the connective tissue, is the primary spermatocyte. Primary spermatocyte, which has differentiated from the spermatogonia, it is germinal epithelial tissue, get divided and becomes in the form of primary spermatocyte. And the another cell, which was I was saying, that is the Sertoli cell. These are the two cells, primary spermatocytes, which has been differentiated from the spermatogonia, and the second one is the Sertoli cell. It is present in the germinal epithelial tissue. This primary spermatocyte, it goes for meiotic division. In the first meiotic division, or you can say the meiosis first, it gives the haploid cells. As soon it will go for the meiotic division, it gives rise to the haploid cell, which is 23 in number. The chromosome number is 23, and now it will be termed as secondary spermatocytes. Now it is clear that secondary spermatocyte is formed after the meiosis first of primary spermatocyte. And hence the ploidy level has been reduced. Now it is 23 in number. After second meiotic division, the spermatids, which has been differentiated from the secondary spermatocyte, get transformed into the spermatozoa during the after completion of the second meiosis. Spermatids, which has been differentiated from the secondary spermatocytes, transformed into spermatozoa, transformation of spermatozoa from spermatid, it is termed as spermiogenesis. This is another term, spermiogenesis. Then what is spermiogenesis? Spermiogenesis is making of spermatozoa from spermatids. This is only the transformation. There will be no change in the ploidy level. Again, it will be chromosome number will be 23 number. Once again, I am repeating. This is the seminiferous tubule having lined with the interstitial spaces. These spaces contain interstitial cell as well as you can say it leading cell after the name of the anatomist FV leading. It also contain blood vessels. To have a enlarged view, see the second figure. This is the interstitial space which contains interstitial cell and blood vessels. The spermatogonia, which is termed as primary spermatocytes, has been differentiated after the meiosis 1 and ultimately it gave rise to the secondary spermatocyte, which having chromosome number 23. The secondary spermatocyte differentiated and named as spermatids, which transformed into the spermatozoa. This process is known as spermiogenesis. The next cell, which I have told you that it contains two type of cells, the spermatogonia or the spermatocyte, as well as the Sertoli cell. It is visible over here, the Sertoli cell. The Sertoli cell, it functions in response of FSH. FSH, you can recall the chapter of class 11, chemical control and integration. FSH. FSH is the follicle stimulating hormone. In the response of FSH, the Sertoli cell works. Similarly, you have also heard about the luteinizing hormone. In influence of the luteinizing hormone, leading cell functions. Leading cell, this is the interstitial cell. This leading cell functions with the influence of luteinizing hormone LH, and Sertoli cell is influenced by follicle stimulating hormone. You also remember this, these two hormones get secreted from pituitary under influence of hypothalamus. Okay, hypothalamus stimulates the pituitary. Pituitary releases luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone. Luteinizing hormone makes function of the, allows function to the leading cell. Leading cell, it is responsible for spermatogenesis, where follicle stimulating cell, it influences the function of Sertoli cell. This is all about the structure of the seminiferous tubule as well as the enlarged view of the seminiferous tubule. Lastly, the spermatozoa or the sperm which has been formed over here get released from the seminiferous tubule. From the seminiferous tubule, it get released. The release of the sperms from seminiferous tubule, it is termed as spermiation. Spermiation. So here you have got the three terms: spermatogenesis done by leading cell, making of sperms; spermiogenesis, conversion or transformation of spermatozoa from spermatids; Spermiation, release of sperm, release of sperms from seminiferous tubule. This is end of this lecture. In next lecture, we'll study about detailed structure of sperm. You all are aware, its ploidy level is haploid in nature. You can say the male gamete. So ultimately, while studying this structure, it's clear now how the male gametes get formed inside the testis. This is the end of this lecture. Thank you.